Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Kneon. I'm here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And apparently you're not allowed to take the gay away from Baldur's Gate. You're not allowed to use a mod to straighten out the LGBTQ characters. Or if you do use a mod, you can't host it on Nexus Mods. This is the same forum that would not let anybody get rid of pronouns in Starfield, right? And they won't let you host anything like that there. But they absolutely positively will let you modify a game so it has more LGBTQ.
Right, because it only ever works one way.
So I want to be clear up front before we get into this video. This video is not anti-LGBTQ in any way, shape, or form. All we're saying is it's very curious that mods that straighten characters out, let's put it that way, are forbidden. But other mods are encouraged and even promoted. Mm-hmm. It's a little weird. Yeah, it's a little weird. I mean, personally, I don't mod my games, but there are a lot of people who do mod games, or they buy games specifically to mod them. And there are some mods now that are just absolutely verboten. But we'll talk about this. So before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. You get woohoo if you do.
Woohoo!
So some of these characters aren't going to be woohooing as much. I think if you use these mods. Now, this is weird. This is coming from Polygon. I got a version here from them magazine. This is Ian Walker. This is the guy I thought he got fired. Maybe he got fired from Kotaku. But, hey, isn't this Mike from Stranger Things? I thought it was. It's a guy from kid from Stranger Things. I thought he got fired for writing that PlayStation 5 manifesto, the one where it was like, I can't enjoy my PlayStation 5 because the world's burning or some crap. Unless he was over at Kotaku, now he's over at Polygon. I don't know. They're basically the same site. But infamous Baldur's Gate 3 anti-LGBTQ plus mod removed from Nexus Mods. Again, this is not the first time this happened. Starfield modders simply wanted to take out the pronouns, because it puts the pronouns on when you do the character creation.
Yeah, but the thing is, it was only like, to be fair with the Starfield thing, it was only like one tiny little part.
Right. Like
So,
well, I guess my point of view on that, and I personally do not think it really affected the game that much. I just think the game looks incredibly boring compared to other games like No Man's Sky. But some people, if you want to mod it out, you should be allowed to. And if it's such a minor thing, then why is it such a controversy?
Right,
people
exactly.
Just want to take one little line of text out.
Yeah, it is a minor thing. I don't see what the big deal is.
I don't see what the big deal is, but it's a big deal. So now you cannot straighten out Baldur's Gate either. A ban report posted to the Nexus Mods forum on December 4th announced the removal of a Baldur's Gate 3 mod known to be part of a larger anti-LGBTQ plus mod pack. So apparently there's a whole
bunch. We are for inclusivity and diversity, as long as it goes one way.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. We're for inclusivity and diversity. The report reads, if we think someone is uploading a mod on our site with the intent to deliberately. Okay, so maybe this is the catch here. If we think someone is uploading a mod on our site with the intent to deliberately be against inclusivity and or diversity, then we'll take action against it. Same goes for people attempting to troll other users with mods deliberately to cause a rise. So again, I do not
There's no rise if you change it to a girl. Just saying.
I do not use Nexus Mods. Now, that being said, this is their website. They're allowed to host whatever they want to host and not host whatever they don't want to host. If they think that somebody's doing it to troll people just to be like, oh, look what I did, I straightened out a character or whatever, then yeah, they're like, yeah, we're not gonna do it. But it is curious. It's very, very curious that it doesn't work in reverse. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying. In fact, they have lots of mods out there that add LGBTQ plus content to other games that otherwise don't have it or don't have it in that capacity. So the mod in question is called Sir Aelin by its uploader, and it was billed as a fully immersive male version of Dame Aelin, complete with new, more masculine body for the immortal demigoddess, and over 850 voice lines altered with the help of AI to account for the changes. And it sounds like a simple gender swap on paper.
It does.
It only survived on Nexus Mods for a day before being removed for its prejudiced origins.
But can't you gender swap other characters in other games with mods?
Yes, you can. In fact, we're gonna point to some.
I don't understand it. If you want to gender swap the character, I thought gender swapping was okay.
It is if you're the right kind of person swapping them in the right direction. Mm-hmm. Yes, that's my understanding. So it's part of the larger No Alphabets mod pack, which claims to match medieval status quo by eliminating... Now, this is not what they said. Match medieval status quo by eliminating all LGBTQ plus content from Baldur's Gate 3. In other words, Dame Aelin wasn't turned into a dude as a fun experiment, but to transform her romantic relationship with Isabel, female half-elf cleric, from homosexual to heterosexual. Another part of the mod pack similarly changes the character named Sebastian from male to female so that his romantic history with a potential party member, Astarion, isn't gay.
No alphabets. What if you don't want to play that, though? What if you don't want to play... You want to play character... Okay, I thought you're supposed to just stick in your own lane, right? And you're supposed to just, you know, only, you know, do pretend to be characters that aren't you or that are like you. So if someone wants to stay in their own lane and only play characters that are like them, what's the problem? Like, if you don't want to see those characters in that way, you shouldn't have to. Any more than people who are LGBTQ, if they want to use a mod to change characters they see it the way that they feel comfortable with, should be allowed to do so. That's what I don't understand. Like, what does it matter? Why do I have to watch them be gay, but they don't have to watch them be straight?
Because you're just a bigot.
I just think if you're not comfortable with it, you know, I mean, personally, it doesn't bother me either flipping way. Don't care.
I don't mod my game. Well, I can't say that. I used to mod The Sims.
He did, but it was to make it dirty. But anyway, I don't care. I just leave it as is. That's just what I would do. But some people, like, they whatever reason, don't want to play it if it's a certain way. And if you can mod it to make characters more gay, more LGBTQ, why can't you mod it to make characters more straight so that you're staying in your own lane?
So here's where they're really having a problem with it. And 95% of the time, and I'm going to be honest, and this is an observation, when there's outrage over anti-LGBTQ plus content, it's usually outrage, just boil it down, it's usually outrage over trans content. But 95% of the time, it does seem to be the case, right? So apparently there's a character in here, and I haven't played through Baldur's Gate 3 yet, so Nocturne, a tiefling merchant who is a trans woman. Now it mods her to be a cis man. The mod again alters her model and voice while also giving her a bogus new diary entry about detransitioning after being unhappy with the results of drinking an elixir of sex shifting.
Okay, well, why would they do
that? Well, okay. I mean, like, this is obviously
true. If only it was as easy as drinking an elixir, right?
The voice change is particularly insidious, seeing as Nocturne is played by Abigail Thorne, a trans woman, known as Philosophy Tube on YouTube. Since its debut on October 14th, No Alphabets has been updated several times based on suggestions from users of a niche RPG forum.
It's only niche because they want to say it's... I mean, I don't know if it is or not, but it probably... If it is, it might be, but it's probably not. They're saying that to justify...
Apart from apparently taking issue with the game's LGBTQ plus content, several comments have also asked the creator to modify characters with vitiligo. I don't know why a skin pigment eliminating autoimmune disorder is a new front and bigoted gamer resentment, but I guess reasonable people should prepare to count on that being an issue. And they're bringing this up. Starfield, the pronoun issue, that was removed. And apparently there was, and I missed this one.
Oh, I knew about it.
They took the pride flags out of Spider-Man or Spider-Man 2. Basically, I think what they did is they unlocked, if I remember correctly, the Middle Eastern version of the game did not have the pride flags, and they basically unlocked it. It wasn't like they put anything there. They were like, no, we're just going to run it. So it's the Middle Eastern version.
But what I'm hearing is you can't do, because you're taking out stuff that represents us. We're mad. Even though you don't identify the way we do, but you're mad. But yet we can take everything that represents you and change it to what we want, and that's completely fine. I'm like, if you can do it one way, you should be able to do it the other way.
Well,
that's where I'm at.
That's
the
thing.
I'm like, if it's good for the goose, it's good for the gander, guys.
So I was going to say, well, okay, if they're against modding a character's sexuality at all, or adding more sexual overtones or whatever to a game, and they want to just say, hey, if you're going to mod a game, it's going to mod the graphics, or it's going to mod, you know, the gameplay or something that isn't related to a character's identity, right? If that were the rule across the board, and that's the
way. If it was the same rule for everybody.
But it's not the case, because this is coming from a site called Gaming Mag, which I can only assume is given it's the home of queer geek culture, that this is all LGBTQ related content. But there are mods, and these are all hosted on Nexus. Female Joker and Persona 5. Same-sex couples and LGBT families in Fallout 4 from Nexus Mods. You can add same-sex couples. The biggest BS move Bethesda ever pulled outside of Fallout 76 is the fact they didn't include any same-sex options in the beginning intro for Fallout 4. So I think they're overcompensating with Starfield then, I think, because of the backlash.
Backlash. Okay, there really wasn't much. I mean, I'll try to be a dick. Or a vagina, take your pick. But the thing is, it's like, you know, you hear about this quote-unquote backlash, and it's usually a small group of people that are mad about it. Most people don't even give a shit. They just play the game as is. They don't even mod it or care.
So,
but this whole idea that one side can do whatever they want, but another side can't is absolute shit. Across the board, either all or nothing across the board.
That would be the fair way, I think, to handle it. Would just be like, look, we're not going to allow any mods that allow for the changing of characters' gender identity one way or the other. And that's going to be a rule across the board just because it's a really dicey situation. But again, it's their form. They can do whatever they want to do. But players don't have to support them if they don't want to either.
But here, like, despite being able to romance... Wait, go back up here. The Fallout thing. Despite being able to romance whoever you want, the characters are being player sexual in the intro forces gay players to either be a man or a woman. Well, then, but you're arguing that in Baldur's Gate, it's forcing straight people to have to, you know, sit through the same thing, but it's okay if they have to sit through it.
Yes.
I mean, again, most people aren't going to give a shit either way.
The majority of people are not going to care.
They're like, ha, 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 whatever, it's a game. Most people don't care.
All right, so Stardew Valley, which I always thought was a pretty queer-friendly game to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, we need more queerness. They said there's a game that has a lot of queer mods out there. Stardew Valley has everything you could think to add, pride marches, banners, etc. All of this is necessary because while the game allows you to date whichever character you want, regardless of gender, it doesn't stop the world of Pelican Town from being pretty heteronormative. This is where the expansion comes in.
Look, I don't play Stardew Valley too much. I play other games like it. And here's the thing. It's like, if you do this and you want to add that mod as a straight person, I don't care. Knock yourself out. You are allowed to have that option. If you want to make the Fallout characters, you know, gay or lesbians, whatever, don't care. Knock yourself out. So why do you care if people want to do it the opposite way? You're not playing the game. They are. You don't even know who's using the mod.
If the purpose is to make the game more user-friendly, more tailored for the individual, and people want to do it. I mean, look, these mods are, regardless of whether or not Nexus Mods host them, they're going to be circulated anyway. And actually what this does is it has the opposite effect, because nobody would have talked about it if Nexus Mods didn't make such a big deal about banning it. Right?
Right.
They would have been like, oh, okay.
But you're allowing the Stardew Valley people to put all these mods in for that kind of stuff, but you're not allowing people to mod it in the opposite way. That's why I'm having a problem. It's like, I don't really care what you do either way, because that's up to you and you're the player. It's your game. And if you're going to complain about straight people not being comfortable with watching your gay scenes, then why are you mad? How come it's okay that, you know, you don't want to watch straight scenes? You know what I mean? I'm like, the hypocrisy is the heart of the whole issue.
Now, on the plus side, you know, the way AI is going, eventually games and movies and all that, this interactive entertainment, it'll be spun up to order. It'll be a la carte. You'll be able to tell the entertainment bot what you want to see, what kind of shows you want to see, and it'll just spin it up for you. So you don't have to worry about any of that stuff in another 10 to 20 years, probably. LGBT mod pack in Sims 4. I remember when Sims 4 came out, there was a lot of controversy because I don't think the characters actually have genders per se, male and female. I think you just kind of create a body type. And that was an issue for a lot of people.
Sims is actually one of the most, I would argue, one of the most inclusive ones, because you can really do so much with it. I know Pinky Boo plays Sims all the time, and she'd have straight couples, gay couples, whatever. She just, you know, she didn't care. She liked everybody.
Yeah, so this, you can add your sexuality in the traits menu.
Yes.
Yeah, it's also helpful in ensuring which Sims do not interact romantically or sexually. Don't worry, there's a lot more this mod pack has to offer.
Don't really want to know.
Craftable pride flags for Fallout 4. You can add
that. But you can do that.
Sure.
But you can, don't you dare remove the pride flags or in general, or you're a horrible person.
Okay.
See, that's why there's a double standard here.
Stardew Valley. These are all Nexus Mods too, right? Yeah, Nexus Mods is the same place that, took away the other mods. Another Stardew Valley. This is gender neutrality. So you've got Alex here saying, you're the new guy, huh? Cool. And you add the gender neutrality. So you're the new farmer, huh? Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Very minor thing. Now, again, a lot of the game publishers now
Nexus Mods.
They're doing it themselves anyway, because they've got their sensitivity readers and stuff. You know what I'm saying? So what's this one? Pride hoodies and Mass Effect Andromeda, which nobody plays.
If it's like already in the game and it's built in the game, but you can choose whether or not you want to, what you want to do. Andromeda no plays. Yeah, I heard you. Batman with a rainbow. You can, if it's already built into the game and you can.
He's wearing a pride flag for a cape. Sorry.
I mean, if it's, you have a choice. Then you should be, I mean, you have a choice. I think that's how we should do it, because if you want, they give you choices and you can custom tailor the game to what you want. But if the games don't offer you choices, if it's okay to go ahead and put mods to give Batman a pride flag cape, then why is it not okay to mod that you take the pride flag cape off of Batman? You know what I mean?
He's wearing a pride flag.
You're very entertained by this. Why does that make you laugh so hard?
I don't know. It's just ridiculous. It's so ridiculous, but DC Comics would totally publish this now. You know they would. It's just, I didn't expect it. I'm scrolling down. Oh, like, yeah, like, it's like, oh my God, Batman is wearing a pride flag for a cape. Yeah, Batman's gay now. He wears his cape of pride in order to beat down the most ominous heterosexual of all, the Joker.
Oh my Harley God. Quinn, Harley Quinn and Poison Ivy were just out, have friends, and then that whole thing went down, you know, the way it has lately.
Same-sex romance, Mass Effect 2, nobody gives a shit.
We don't have to go through all these. You get the idea.
Nexus mods.
There's Nexus mods that are available. But if there's something that goes that removes this content,
it's a problem.
It's a problem. But if they can add all this content in, you know, so that these people feel like they're seen, then that's okay. But you're not allowed to tailor the content to what you're comfortable with because you're a bigot.
What's this link? Oh, yeah, Rainbow Batman. There we go. That's not what they meant. But, God, so there we go, guys. You can't take the gay away on Nexus Mod, but you certainly can.
Add
it in.
Personally, I don't care. I don't care if the game has it in it. It's not something I would change because I don't usually do the mods. But if someone wants to change it either way, if you can do it on one side, you should be able to do it on the other. That's just what I'm saying. You can't, like, ban it. So, or no one can do it on one way, but then everybody can do it the other side. No.
Look,
they're killing all the people that are LGBTQ or something like that. Well, that's different.
That's different. But we just want to turn the... Yeah, I mean, again, it sounds... Like, I would say that they're just like, look, the purpose of this mod was just to troll, so we're going to ban it. But they banned other things, too, that weren't explicitly trying to troll. Like, the removing the pronouns, because some people were like, that's a really stupid thing to add to the character creation screen. And it's a very simple thing to patch.
Side of that, really, you just go past it. Just hit what your pronoun is and move on. I mean,
I don't see
the big deal either way. But
so, yeah, I don't know. I don't mod games. I just don't buy games that I don't want to play. You know, it's
yeah, just don't play the games, I guess.
I guess, you know. You'd think publishers would be like, oh, please. Because that's what they were talking about Starfield to try to save it. They're like, well, the modding community is going to have a field day with this one. They'll fix all the stuff that's broken with it. I'm not talking about the pronouns. I'm talking about the game itself. And they're apparently not even bothering, or people aren't going to bother because they're like, well, we can't mod anything anyway, so whatever. Whatever.
Don't play it. So.
Don't play it, and then sales plummet, and that's it. So anyway, we're going to wrap this up.
Yep.
Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. Talk later.
Bye.